Hello students, how are you doing? I hope you are fine and happy Ramadan. So let's continue our courses, and today we are going to see a grammar lesson. And we are going to talk or to see a new course grammar. Okay, so let's take a look at these first sentences. We have here sentences. The first one, if you are thirsty, the robot will make you a nice cup of hot chocolate. Sentence number two, if you are tired, it'll do your homework. It means it will do your homework. Number three, if you are bored, it'll sing you a song. It means it will sing you a song. So look at these sentences, and if you take a look, we will find this word, if, and this word, will, are written in bold. It means they are important in this sentence. So, what is the meaning of if? If you are thirsty, the robot will make you a nice cup of hot chocolate. So that's mean if. So this is another expression in English. So we use if with conditional or conditional sentences. So here, there is a condition here. If you are thirsty, this is the condition. And this is the next other sentence of condition. So the condition here is, if you are thirsty, the robot will make you a nice cup. So here, we have two sentences in one sentence. So we call them two clauses in one sentence. This is the big sentence, and this is the first clause and the second clause. The first clause, we call it if clause, okay? If clause. So our course for today is presenting and practicing if clause. It means the clause in which we use the word if. So the next sentence, if you are tired, it'll do you homework. It'll do, or it will do your homework. So here we have to look and to another thing here in this, in all these sentences. The first clause, we have if with a verb. The second sentence, we have will with a verb. And if you take a look at all these words, verbs, you will find in if clause, we have present, and in the second clause, we have will, it means future, okay? So here have the same sentences. If you are thirsty, the robot will make you a nice cup of hot chocolate. So here, if and will, we call them the expression of will, if clause. And here are and make, they are the verbs. I read them in red in order to separate them. For example, here, you are is present, but make with will, it means future, will make. Okay, and here, this is the form of how to form, for example, clauses with if. So if, and write subject, verb, object, then comma, then subject, will, and object, then finish. Okay, for example, if I am thirsty, okay, I will get a cup of water, for example. So we have two sentences, subject, verb, object, the first sentence with if, and the second sentence with will, okay? As I told you, the first verb who is going with if is in present. The second verb who is going with l or will is in future. Whenever we have will, it means future. Will think, will make, will take, okay? Will do, all these are future. Okay, so here we have the same the same picture, but now you have to mime or to do this game as miming. For example, between you, you have, for example, to work in pairs. And for example, the first sentence, if you are hungry, I'll make you a sandwich. So here, the first boy is miming a robot. Okay, so he's doing like he's a robot, and he is talking to the other student, and he is giving, for example, a promise. If you are hungry, I will make you a sandwich. Okay, so we will do this exercise or this game in our meeting, inshallah. Now let's move to the exercises. Here we have two exercises in this in the page, in page 95 in your workbook. So you have to make, okay, and practice these if clauses. Okay, so for the first one, exercise number one, you have to look and match. Look, it means look at this picture and look at these sentences, then match. You have to match between the first set of sentences with the second set of sentences. What do we have in the first sentence? For example, if you can do your maths homework, I'll take you to the swimming pool. Okay, if you see the first, all the first set of sentences are started with if. It means these are if clauses. And the other sentences are the second clauses for the sentence. So they all of them start with I will. So read these sentences and match the correct ones. In the second exercise, you have to read these sentences, okay, and write the missing words. For example, you have here a box is full of words. You have to write these words in each line and use will. So for example, the first one, if you are scared of monsters, I'll fight them. It means I will fight them. So we take the verb fight from the box and we use will. Okay, and here is the robot who is talking. So whenever you use a word here, write I. Okay, so I will or I'll, and then choose the verb from the box. Okay, so I hope you good luck in these two exercises, and in our meeting we are going to correct them together, inshallah. So take your time and see you then.